So Sifu says, yeah, since you understand that that's really our third stage is Mingxin, which is to have an enlightened heart, an enlightened understanding. A lot of times when we understand something, it's a partial understanding. It's not a full and immersive or deep understanding necessarily. Within Kung Fu specifically, you know, it's a lot of times we might have a partial understanding on the exterior or not a total full body understanding, but a partial body understanding or partial understanding. Also a little bit of background is that Mingxin, that term, an enlightened heart, that there's a very clear specialized term within Buddhism, as you know. You know, to be enlightened is very associated with Buddhism, and it's not something we can necessarily cover and achieve in a conversation, right? And that's so. The idea there is that for us to focus on stage one, zhenxin, stage two, lianxin, so that once you fully understand those two stages, your third stage becomes obvious or present. So you know, from a Buddhism standpoint, it's vast what that content is. So, but from within Kung Fu, you know, Mingxin, the concept of Mingxin, you know, enlightened understanding, is you know, we'll take it from that approach, from within in the context of Kung Fu, right? And a lot of times, so the classic example that we use in class is, just because you intellectually understand the move, it doesn't mean your body understands that move. And so to have... So you know, many times...
So
Yes. So so Sifu was saying that to understand, you know, a lot of times in class he'll ask Misan, do you understand? And Misan says yes, I do. But when you actually do it, Misan, it's not there. It's not right. You know, it's not. It may not even be what he taught, right? So so there is that. There's definitely that disconnect, and namely, it's that to intellectually to kind of understand it from. To understand a kung fu movement in your heart, in your mind, and your heart is the first stage. But to understand it physically, understand it in every part of your body, it's a necessary step.
Because 比较深了，大脑的话，我们讲那个腹部还没有真正的明白，还空空的。So
then, right. So then now we're getting a little bit more detailed and more, you know, but probably a little bit deeper than what we can handle. But you know, namely, it's, you know, because your brain understands, your mind, your brain understands something. I'm going to say your brain, just because you intellectually grasp, your brain understands something, your 丹田, or your 腹部, like your midsection, doesn't understand. This information is residing in your brain, but it's not residing within
your
commonly the common description is that the common understanding is that it's our brain that controls our physical movement.
根据我的经验呢，就是说，大脑控制这个自己的运动，我不否认这个，但是不完全对。不完全对，
right? So it's not completely. So that's not completely, the way it is according to Sifu's experience. That you know, sure, he doesn't dispute that the brain controls your faculties, right. You know, your physical movements. He doesn't dispute that, but it's not the full story. You know, it's part of the story. That, it's not the full story. So right. So let's say your brain in this case, right, is can control the movements of your arms and your legs, and you can. But in Sifu's experience, it's not, that isn't the full story.
I think you said before, it starts as a thought first, then you move.
Frame it in a question for me.
Does it start as a thought first?
Misan 问说是动作是不是从一个意念开始?
你现在这个知道表现，你的意念从哪里来的？从心。So
where does your thought come from?
心。心。你们只是知道大脑在想，你们知道自己也在想。
So you might think that we're all thinking that, you know, our brains are thinking about considering things. You know, have you considered that, you know, perhaps your 丹田, your abdomen is also deliberating. Needs to do.
我给你们打个比喻哈，就是
here's an analogy.
当你们做动作，哎呀，做的不顺的时候。 那你有没有检查腹部？没有。不顺的时候，可以肯定了，腹部都是坑的。
When you when you're not smooth with your movement, right? It's almost certain that your 丹田, your 腹部, midsection is empty.
或者说，当你铁拿住你了，锁住你的时候，你的腹部也是空的。对，拿着就不是了，拉什么，不是你的腹部就都是空了。你的当你的腹部。 死的时候，别人拿不住你，你的动作就不会不顺。
That won't be So when you once you've been locked, you know, if you at that moment when you examine your 丹田 or your midsection, it's almost certainly empty. So that's just something that you wanna examine when you're either when you're locked or in executing a form when you're not smooth. It's
deliberate.所以这一点就是说，我们光靠我们的大脑，我们现在是在这种的，它是不够的。要靠这个大脑呢，它是属于先天的，先天的，有先天就有后天，是不是？先天呢是。 通过就是我们刚才讲的，就是通过我们的神经，就是我们现在讲的在运动里都是通过神经系统的运动。嗯。那有没有听说过说后天的经络系统，在中国的传统啊，经络系统是后天的。嗯。他们后天的可以帮助先天。
只有先天后天能够balance，才一切都顺利。Yeah, so先天的is, there's, you know, sort of, I want to say, naturally given, you know, what you're quote unquote God given, you know. So, you know, our brains and our nervous system, that's all sort of, so everyone's given that set of capacity, you know, organs, that's 先天. 后天 is sort of what after through life we've, you know, with the presence of these our bodily organs, there's the presence of, for example, the energy paths, right, which obviously rely on the presence of what's God given, your various organs in your body. Right, so your energy paths and the various, so that's those two pieces. You know, what's God given and what comes later on needs to balance. Mm-hmm.